Howdy, what's going on, everybody, and welcome to a brand new video on Sword Art Online Alicization Licorice. My name is Vinus SGN. Sword Art Online AL has a few updates coming to the game soon to address some of the bugs and glitches that overall ruin the gaming experience. This month, August, somewhere around the end of the month, it's been reported that there will be an update to the game. The last update, 1.03, improved system stability and quality of life, as well as brought over a few new costumes. This late August update will supposedly bring much-needed camera fixes, as well as features for quicker loading and quicker saving. I know that far from addresses all the issues that the game has currently, though more improved system stability could cover a wide variety of topics. In September, there is said to be another update to the game, though timing on that is unclear right now, but this patch will directly address loading screen times and frame rate drops. Apparently, these two updates will be the quote-unquote final adjustment to these aspects of the game, which leads me to believe that they released the game knowing that it still needed work before it was completely finished, but still it was in a playable state. After the September update, it said that there will be no more issues with frame drops across all platforms. The producer for the game has stated that these are the final updates, but if there should be a problem in the future, they will go back and fix them as needed. Also in September, there will be new game modes added to Sword Art Online Alicization Licorice, one called Semi-Auto Mode, or something similar to that, which basically is easy mode for combo chaining, making it easier for players to link their weapon skills by pressing one button. Now, I'm not sure how this will work exactly, but this mode will be optional. Another mode will drop at the same time that basically turns SAOAL into what amounts to a visual novel. This mode will pretty much just focus on cutscenes and reading and will be shorter than the original game. Along with these new modes, raids are getting an update as well. Apparently, the raid update will store data on the characters that you choose for raids and what role you have them playing. I'm guessing this is so you will no longer have to handpick your teammates in raids when playing the game offline and solo. Now, if you were hoping to hear some news for DLC for the game anytime soon, do not get your hopes up. Take your time, grind the game as much as you want to get the best in-game gear, because no DLC has been announced yet, and there are no plans to even start working on DLC until after all of the base game stuff is completed and the game is upgraded to the state that it should have been at launch. Now, we may hear news in October about DLC, but that is the most we can hope for. Now, are there any specific bugs and glitches that you have ran into in the game so far playing that you definitely think needs to be addressed? There's one glitch in particular that I keep running into that I have a serious problem with that just disturbs the way that I play the game, and that's the fact that whenever there is a relic beast somewhere on the map, my character can't get them to spawn in. I actually have to switch characters to get them to spawn in, and that creates a whole mess of problems for my buffs and sacred arts that I want to channel. It just kind of ruins the entire gaming experience when I am playing solo. If you have anything that's annoying like that, any glitches that you've encountered, please drop those down in the comment section below so I can make a video and basically, you know, call them on their stuff and be like, hey, yo, these are issues that need to be fixed. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll catch you next time. Peace out.